my battle. If you can't lift your hands in worship, it probably means you are holding a tool to fight. And once you are holding a tool to fight, God stands back. Immediately he said, Lord, I drop my weapon. I want to use praise and worship. You can open up your heart. You can open up your spirit. So when you go through the rolling pin process, you become flat. You were puffed up, now you are flat. God is looking to flatten some egos in the house today.
Yes. Mm.
Egos.
Mm.
That's powerful way. Can I pray to the men?
Yeah.
Men, suppress your egos.
Amen.
I learned something from Abraham. Abraham listened to his wife. Made a mistake, and when it was time for correction, God spoke through the woman right back to the man and said, man, you have to let that child go. See, sometimes as a man you have to repress your ego for God to be able to use your wife. Amen. Can I preach to the woman? Woman, sometimes you have to put your opinion on the side and let God use the man to roll you with the pin. I'm not talking physical. Hallelujah.
Amen.
After you go through the rolling pin process, something that used to be very round and shaped, now you become flat. You become flat. People cannot see you. Everybody is looking down on you. So God looks at you and says, yes, maybe you are ready. You see, if you ask the professional bakers, they sometimes use the rolling pin about 10 times in a process to get every air bubble out. Because one thing about air bubbles is that they don't have substance, but they make you puffed up.
Pretty sure.
Like the police, where I come from. Where I come from, the police don't have power, but they walk like, you know. Meanwhile, here in America, you can hear an ambulance that sounds like the police, and you are afraid. You see, God is looking to suppress those ego bubbles of air. You see, when you are down to your real size, you are comfortable. You don't have to impress anybody. You are who you are. What you see is what you get. And that is what God is looking for. Those air bubbles, press them down. And just when you think that you are at your flattest and nothing can come out of you, then God begins to pour his Holy Spirit, which we call yeast. You see, what yeast does is that yeast has a fungus in it, and it causes a chemical reaction. So something that is flat, all of a sudden it begins to rise. So here you were lying down prostrate, you were worshiping God, and then the yeast is poured in you, and then you begin to rise. You begin to rise. People who used to look down on you, all of a sudden begin to look at you. So was this not that gentleman who used to work 12 to 12, 11 to 7, whatever schedule he used to have, and then God begins to raise you up?
Hallelujah.
I don't know what stage of the bread process you are. Maybe you have just gone through the rolling pin, and so even your family have decided that your last name, which they share, they will change theirs and put an apostrophe on there. Oh, it happens. Because they don't want to associate with your failure. But I came to announce to you that God is about to pour some yeast upon some of us who are ready to be flattened. I don't know about you, but if you are ready to lay down prostrate before God, he's going to pour some yeast upon your life. See, yeast is not really respected because it's, you know, it's like nobody respects it. But like David, if you hold on, God will use that very stone, that killed the bear, that very stone. But you see, just when you think that you're about to rise, God puts you in a container and puts you in an oven. The open process too is not something that as Christians we like. I mean, when the winter comes, we complain. But when the summer comes and it's 75 degrees, you can hear them. It's too hot. It's too hot. Amen. So you can imagine going into an oven. You know, an oven is useless until the fire comes on. It is when the fire comes on, that is when the yeast begins to work. So that like Paul and Silas, you have been flattened by the rolling pin, and you are in prison, all prayers have been said. Even the one who promised to get you a phone call while in prison, his shift has turned over. The Bible says it was midnight when they decided to lift up praise. You see, there's something about praise. There's something about praise. The Bible says that our praise is like a sweet smelling fragrance. You see, when the bread is in the oven and it begins to bring that aroma, even people who have no taste begin to smell it and say, there is something coming on here. You see, because the yeast is working, the fire is burning, and that which is within you. You know what makes the difference? It's the fire. Because this thing, you can't smell it. Oh, but let them put on the oven in that kitchen. And let us do praise and worship for 35 minutes. Yeah. Some of you will forget that we are fasting this month. Because through the fire, the best that is within you will come out. I came to announce to you this morning that there are certain things in you. Unless you humble yourself and let the baker put you in the fire, it will never come out. You might look like the shape of that which you ought to be, but until the scent comes out. So Jesus, at the peak of his ministry, doing miracles, raising the sick, or raising the dead, healing the sick, it's time for him to go to the cross. The Bible says he goes into the garden and tells the disciples to wait for me. Some of us, we don't go into the fire because we always want prayer partners. I came to announce to you that there are certain prayers. It ought to be just you and your God. Not even your husband can help you. Not even your husband knows the problem. Even if they know, like Elkanah, they think that, what we have is good. Meanwhile, when you sleep, you can't sleep. I came to announce to you that the open experience, you go it alone. The open experience, the intercessory department cannot help you. Actually, when you are going through the open process and you call me, my phone might be on voicemail. But if you will hold on, if you will hold on, amen. You see, the higher they turn up the heat, the more the fragrance comes out. You see, sometimes they shut the door of the oven, and yet the fragrance is so strong that you have to open the windows of your house. I came to announce to you that if you are in the open process, get ready, because what God is about to do, it cannot be contained in your house. It cannot be contained. You can shut the windows, it will still find a way. So Jesus goes through the open process after being shaped. And you see, just when you think that